In this, we'll see now wireless threats. We have seen previously that wireless encryption protocols like WEP, WPA, and WPA2, and their comparison. Now we'll see what are the wireless threats possible, and these encryption standards can prevent these attacks. The first threat that you can see is access control attack. Basically, any encryption standard or any security method will be designed to safeguard the CIA triangle, that is confidentiality, integrity, and authentication. So we'll see one by one what are the possible attacks on confidentiality, integrity, and authentication. Here a list of possible attacks were given here. Wireless threats are like this: access control attacks. It aims to avoid the wireless LAN access control measures. Access control in the sense who can access which access point. So everyone cannot access every access point, but there will be a limitation that some group of users can use only one access point like that. Here first one is war driving. War driving in the sense attacker will use some powerful devices, and he will sit in a car and will roam around the organization, or outside of the organization or within the organization or campus, so that he can come to know what are the access points that are available in the particular locality, and he may record all the access points and also the MAC address of those access points, since the access points are visible whenever you open any Wi-Fi or something in your mobile phone. Automatically it will show you what are the access points available there. So, but here the attacker will use the powerful tools and also some specialized software to track the message authentication codes and access mechanism, security mechanisms used by the access points. Thereby, he try connecting by sitting outside of the organizational network, organization campus or the campus. Then he will try breaking one access point by one access point using some specialized tools. Okay, next one is rogue access points. Rogue access points were the access points or fake access points was installed by the hackers. Next is MAC spoofing. This is MAC spoofing is message authentication code, because all the wireless devices will be having their MAC addresses along with the IP address set to it. So MAC addresses spoofing is very important, because they may fabricate some new MAC packets, MAC addresses, and may attach to the rogue access points. Access point misconfiguration. During this war driving, that attacker may also check for the misconfigurations in the access points, because sometimes the network engineer might have not changed the default access settings. First they will check with the default access settings like admin user and admin password and this kind of thing, and they will try to uncover any misconfiguration errors are there. Next one is ad hoc access associations. Ad hoc associations means all the wireless devices especially used for the ad hoc communication. Ad hoc means on the fly. Okay, whenever they want they can communicate, whenever they don't want they can disconnect. So ad hoc associations will be sent to the access point. If they respond to it, they will be connected. Otherwise, they will try for attacker will try other possibilities. Next one is promiscuous client. Here promiscuous client means here the wireless device used by the client will open the monitor mode and will try to monitor all the packets that are passing through the access point. Promiscuous mode is a mode where the network interface will be ready to capture all packets which are not intended to the client also, or every packet will be received. Next is client misassociation and unauthorized association. So these are the various access control attacks will be carried out by the attacker. Next, integrity attack. It aims to send forged control management or data frames over the wireless networks to misdirect the wireless devices. So especially the wireless the message that is transmitted over the wireless network will be misleaded by tampering the integrity. The data frame injection is an injection attack. Basically, in order to inject the data frame, all hardware will not be supported. Some specialized hardware will be there that we'll see in the tutorial sections also. some specialized hardware will be there. We are supposed to use those hardware, then only it is possible to inject the data frames into the wireless communication, especially Wi-Fi communication. So you may purchase those hardware devices. Your laptop Wi-Fi and your general computer Wi-Fis will not support the features of monitoring and injection. So you need to purchase, if you want to practice Wi-Fi hacking, then you need to purchase some specialized hardware that I will discuss in the tutorial section. So in India, you will find that Wi-Fi device for around 700 to 800 rupees. And there are some other powerful tools also there, where you have powerful hardware is also there, which will be having capability of around 200 meters or 300 meters capability. That will, as the range increases, obviously the cost also increases, and the number of features increases, like especially like injection and tampering and this kind of thing, spoofing and this kind of capabilities are there, then also the rate also increases. I will give you a version which is a very basic version, and you can easily practice that with the Kali Linux and with that particular hardware, which cost around 750 to 800 rupees. I will give the Flipkart link also in the tutorial that will be posted in the next week. Next, the data frame injection and the WEP injection, that is wide equivalent privacy injection, bit flipping attacks. Bit flipping in sense, whatever the encryption will be done, that will be in form of bit level, because these are the stream ciphers. Stream ciphers will use the bit by bit. In case of block ciphers, will use block of bits. Here, whatever the encryption mechanisms used in our encryption protocols are all of stream ciphers. So bit flipping means just if you change from one bit to other bit and transmit over the network, obviously the CRC will fail or method authentication will fail. Thereby, that particular data will be dropped by the receiver. So this bit flipping attacks extensible access point replay and data replay and installation vector replay attacks, radius replay attacks. That means here, whenever this replay was there, replay attacks are there. Here, some fake points will be placed, and instead of the actual point, this fake point will send the replay. Wireless network wirelesses. Whenever you connect to any wireless network, automatically, first, once the handshake was completed, immediately the virus will be injected into your device. This is one method with which this integrity attacks will be performed. Next one is confidentiality attacks. It aims to intercept the confidential information sent over wireless association. In this, the most common thing is eavesdropping. Next one is honeypot access point. Honeypot access point is one which will be created by the attacker itself, as showing that there in a especially in the shopping areas and all. In those places, usually they used to create fake access points, such as by keeping the renowned restaurants' names, etc. So thereby the users usually will try to connect those access points, and they will give you they will project it as a restaurant's Wi-Fi, and when the client try to connect it immediately, without any password or something, directly it will be connected. And client will feel that, okay, we have connected to this and we can enjoy the internet over there. But actually it will be connected to the hacker's point, which are called honeypot access point. And traffic analysis, session hijacking, cracking wireless encryption, wired equivalent privacy key is also one point where confidentiality attacks will perform. Masquerading, evil twin access point. So twin access point, but these are the evil points. Man in the middle attack. So here session hijacking, in the sense here, whenever it was connected to the rogue access point or honeypot access point, whenever the client is trying to browse any electronic commerce site or any banking network for transaction, then that session ID will be spoofed, and that session will be utilized by the access point by disconnecting the switching off the access point by the hacker. So thereby you will connect to that access point and you will browsing the internet. All of a sudden the internet will be disconnected, as your session ID was spoofed by the attacker. At his computer he will use the same session ID and will connect to the same electronic commerce site and or the banking site and will transfer your funds or will do whatever the malicious activity he wants. So that is what the session hijacking over here. Next one is mask voiding and evil PIN access point. So cracking WEP key that we'll see afterwards in the next lectures, because WEP and key encryption key cracking requires some step-by-step procedure that we can use here A-Crack NG to do this. I will discuss in the next lecture. This man-in-the-middle attack. So this is also like our general man-in-the-middle attack. Once you know, understand the session hijacking, it is not a big task to understand the man-in-the-middle attack. In the session hijacking, he may disconnect the access point, and here in the MITM, the same session will be maintained, but the client will always think that okay, he is connected to the actual server, but he will be connecting to the attacker server. Availability attacks, it aims to prevent the legitimate users from accessing the resources in a wireless network. So access point theft, it is a physical theft may be done. Disassociation attacks, EAP failure attacks, beacon flood. So beacon floods means in the sense whenever any wireless device connects to the access point, first the beacon will be sent, the hello packets will be sent. Based upon the hello packets, it will come to know that what is the access point name, SSID, etc. So beacon flood will be done, thereby you won't give the time to respond, thereby it may lead to denial of service also. So denial of service, deauthentication flood, routing attacks, where it will disturb the routing table, and authenticate flood, ARP cache poisoning, power saving attacks, TKMP, MIC, exploit attack. So these are the major possible attacks. For this also you need to understand the powerful tools. We are not seeing all these attacks and all these possible things, but you should know what are the attacks possible on the wireless devices. Finally, authentication attacks. It aims to steal the identity of Wi-Fi clients. Especially these authentication attacks will focus on disturbing the handshaking procedure used in the Wi-Fi authentication. In this PSK cracking, so this PSK, whenever you crack the PSK, obviously the identity can be theft. Whenever you crack the leap access, that is what we have seen previously, leap cracking leads to shared key guessing. What is the shared key? WPN login cracking leads to password speculation. Domain login cracking leads to application login theft. So these are the places, if you crack this, automatically this kind of authentication can be leaked out. But doing cracking of a PSK leap which is having higher long lengthy key is somewhat difficult task, but you require to have some powerful tools. We'll see those tools and methodology in the next lecture.